Hello, my name is Sam Michelle, and my presentation for you today will briefly explore the concept of art rock. Now, in the book Musical Worlds, New Directions in the Philosophy of Music, John Fisher said that rock does not just challenge traditional assumptions of taste. It is not a simplistic musical medium. Its mode of existence is significantly different from classical or even earlier pop music. However, I hope that by the end of this presentation, you understand why I believe this to be a contradiction. Art rock is a multifaceted branch of rock music that emerged in the British psychedelic scene of the late 1960s and flourished in the early to mid 1970s. Practically all groups at the time were British in origin, and the very first group to combine rock with classical music in their 1967 album Days of Future Past were the Moody Blues. Now, what is art rock? Some characteristics of this genre are that it attempts to combine rock with classical, symphonic, or even literary elements. Of course, this means classical instrumentation, including symphonic orchestras and pseudo-orchestral ensemble playing. Part of its appeal lies in its instrumental virtuosity, which also includes complicated and frequent rhythm changes. Its literary facet lies partly in its imaginative and complex lyrics, which include socio-political, philosophical, and sometimes even science fiction themes. This leads to an elaborate and conceptual approach to the music, which they employ mainly through unified and extended compositions, which are typically known as concept albums that feature a cycle of songs that express a particular theme or idea throughout. Art rock is also purposeful, meaning that it's meant to actively be listened to and contemplated, not just played or in the background or danced to. It finds resonance in a criticizable middle ground, and as quoted from the All Music Guide to Rock, the definitive guide to rock, pop, and soul, devotees of progressive rock have to fend off more vilification than fans of almost any other rock genre. Purebred rock and rollers scorn it for lacking rock's earthier and poppier elements, while scholars of classical and serious music find it too simple and undemanding to merit attention. Thankfully, this hasn't stopped modern groups from embracing it. One of these is Red, a band that hails from Nashville, Tennessee. The meaning of the band's name is the blood of Christ and what it represents, passion, pain, but ultimately redemption. And in Michael Barnes, the lead vocalist's own words, it's a power color, a very emotional thing. Their mission statement and their goal as a band is to connect those hard-earned fans with the stories being told through their music. And their signature sound includes quote-unquote sonic layering, rich orchestration, and visceral dynamics. Now, Red debuted on June 6, 2006 with the album End of Silence. This album was nominated for Best Rock or Rap Gospel Album in the 2006 Grammys, and their song Breathe Into Me took Rock Recorded Song of the Year in the 2007 Dove Awards, which are basically the Christian Grammys. Almost 3 years later, in 2009, they released Innocence and Instinct. It too was nominated for Best Rock or Rap Gospel Album of the Year in the 2009 Grammys, and their song Start Again took Rock Recorded Song of the Year in this year's Dove Awards. Red has also reported that this album draws inspiration from Dante's Inferno in that it tackles deep issues in a poetic manner, and a car crash that the band experienced where the tour van smashed into a guardrail and slid sideways across the highway, and the quote-unquote heights of horror were channeled into the album. Their most recent album, Until We Have Faces, was released February 1st of this year. Much of their inspiration for this album was drawn from C.S. Lewis's book of the similar title, Till We Have Faces. And they also actually posted on their Facebook page asking fans what they wanted to hear songs about, and the prevalent theme that this uncovered was the search of identity, which is really what their concept album is about. Now I will play a portion of one of these songs, which I believe best exemplifies Red and their art rock characteristics. I hope that this presentation has broadened your horizons to possibly include an appreciation for the combination of two seemingly incompatible styles of music that I actually believe work together very nicely to create a very inspirational genre. Thank you.